Last week, the Minister of Health declared an outbreak of Ebola after a case of the Sudan Ebola virus was confirmed in Mubende District. Since then, confirmed cases and deaths have been increasing and spreading to the neighboring districts. In Parliament, MPs are concerned with the rapid spread of the disease, and as Parliament expects the Minister of Health to make a statement, legislators have raised a lot of questions.
We want to know how many people are sick, how many people have died, whether the ministry has been able to identify the contacts that the sick people could have made and followed up those contacts. We want to know in the homes of the various contacts, people made contact with the victims, whether they are school-going children who go to day schools. And we know that Ebola being a disease that is spread through contact, knowing that children play and they play through making contact, we want to know how vulnerable schools within those areas where the disease is believed to be. We want to know how vulnerable, you know, those children are.
We want to know facts, because we want to know facts. We want to know if there is a team that has been basically put in place to make sure that they attack the virus on the onset when it comes to a community. But people have not been organized. Not even district health officers have been organized. People, yesterday there was a suspect, and the doctors had to run away because they had no equipment. So we have a challenge there.
And finally,
legislators want the Minister of Health to recall all health workers that were laid off earlier this year after the COVID-19 pandemic in order to strengthen capacity and integrity of health facilities. Lawmakers want the president to explain government's response plan to the epidemic and address all concerns that have facilitated the widespread of the disease.
It is regrettable that the medical workers who were recruited during COVID-19 pandemic, trained, got very good experience and exposure in managing an epidemic, in managing a highly infectious environment, that such people were laid off. At a time like this, we need them. I cannot guarantee that we can easily mobilize them. For the months they've been out of work, perhaps some have found job opportunities outside the country. It is very sad that we make gains due to our, you know, past experiences, only to lose those gains at the instance that a pandemic is declared.
Going to the field to meet your voters, you never know. As you interact, you can be affected. And at the same time, when an MP is affected, you will come and affect other fellow members of parliament. Let us take caution, all of us. Take care. Let us not move anyhow. Let us not interact. Let us respect, of course, the guidelines and rules given to us by the Ministry of Health.
The woman member of parliament of Mubende District, Hope Grania Nakazibwe, has urged the president to issue travel restrictions of people in affected districts.
Restricting movements, not locking down, but to ensure that the areas that have suspects are controlled. I think this needs to be done by either health workers, community health workers that are going to be guiding the population or the community on how they are supposed to conduct themselves in order to curb this epidemic. Ebola is one of the epidemics that can easily be controlled, but people have to understand that it is very deadly.
Meanwhile, the Parliamentary Committee of Health, which was tasked to monitor government response to Ebola, is constrained to visit Ebola epicenters, citing fears of contracting the disease. The committee chairperson, Dr. Charles Ayume, says they're going to depend on information from the Minister of Health to inform their report.
As a committee, because it is also an infectious disease, it would be, as a chairperson, it would be suicidal for me to take my committee to go to the field and see where is this Ebola coming from. Let us rely on the goodwill of the Ministry of Health. All we can do is receive information and continue to engage each other, because this is when Ebola comes, this is a war.
Relatedly, Chikuwe District authorities have formed an Ebola task force aimed at curbing the spread of the deadly virus to the district. This has come after two people from Changwali sub-county presented Ebola-like symptoms but later tested negative. The district task force team, headed by the resident district commissioner of Chikube, has established 3 treatment centers in different places of the district.
Being neighbors of Mubende or Chegwegwa in particular, Chikube is at risk. We have had this first task force meeting, and the aim was to ensure that we prepare ourselves for anything, any eventuality. Of course, we know that Ebola is a very infectious disease, and it spreads mainly by contact, and the signs and symptoms are many of which, of course, most of the people are expected to know. We all know that it is characterized by severe headache, fever, joint pains.
Training, the facial training for some of our medical people and the drivers, so that they can be also ready. Basically, that's why we are here. It was very important that we need to meet first as the task force, which I head, including all these medical doctors and our partners and the local leaders.
As of yesterday, the ministry reported 36 Ebola cases in Mubende and Chegwegwa districts. 2 new cases and 2 new deaths were also confirmed yesterday, putting the cumulative number of Ebola-related deaths to 23 and active cases at 36. Report by Godfrey Muhumuza for the news.